Hi guys, welcome to Cannon Hall Farm. Farmer Darrell here, and today we're down at the porcupine enclosure. And as you'll know, we have Cape Porcupine here at the farm. And several months ago, Winnie, a female, was introduced to our resident male, Spike. And the idea behind that is we're hoping for the pitter-patter of little porcupet feet. But is love in the air? So here we are, and right behind me, you can probably see more of Spike than Winnie, and the reason for that is Spike's been very protective of Winnie. They're getting on pretty well. And the problem we've got here is, it's part of the breeding program for us with our exotic animals, which the Cape Porcupine is part of, to have little ones. And it took us time to find the right female for Spike. We needed a younger female, somebody that was quite placid in nature, and that's what we found with Winnie. And it was a little bit prickly, for want of better words, at the start. However, they've got on really, really well after the first few weeks. They're now sharing the same bed. They're sharing the same food. Potatoes, obviously, as you know, is Spike's favourite, and he actually gives them up to Winnie, which is, you know, that's the sign of love. But until recently, we didn't really know if anything was going in the right direction. And I say recently, and that's because it has been seen over the last few days here at Cannon Hall Farm that Spike has indeed got a little bit closer to Winnie. And that's a good sign that in the near future, we will have some little porcupets. They take around 94 days gestation, which is just around 3 months really. So we're looking hopefully towards the early summertime. We should hopefully hear the little pitter-patter of some porcupets. Now we're going to monitor that behaviour. Obviously we'd like to see more results in that behaviour, but the female is only in season for 9 days. So what we've started doing since we've seen this action is more food. We're putting more food in and around the enclosures, in the dens, and that should keep them very comfy, very satisfied. The next step after that will be to put a smaller nest box, if you like, inside one of the larger dens, and because in the wild they would dig an hole, they would go underground potentially. So we're going to make a smaller area where Winnie will feel really comfortable, really warm, and an area that Spike can then protect even better. And like the signs he's already showed us, he's very protective, he's got her behind him, he doesn't want me to come too close, and that hopefully means he's doing his job right, and fingers crossed, and a few more potatoes, we might be on his way to some little ones. So we're all watching, we're all listening, and we've all got our fingers crossed, because it's so important that we get a result out of Spike and Winnie's relationship. So thanks ever so much for joining in and watching us. Hope to see you all very soon live here at the farm. And if you liked and enjoy what you've seen, like it and share it. And hopefully the next time I update you, there could be some little ones around. Thanks very much. Farmer Darrell, Cannon Hall Farm, with Spuds.